So just a few days ago, I recorded a video about a potential merger between a Churchill Capital 4 corporation and a Lucid Motors, okay? The SPAC called Churchill Capital could merge with the Lucid Motors, hence bringing that company public and making you potentially a lot of money. And since that day, that was a Friday, I did a bit more digging around to find the potential clues, facts, and, you know, news whether this is going to happen or not, because in the meantime, also find a lot of risky news and a lot of bad news for a potential merger from CNBC saying that it could be that it's not gonna happen. So before we go into positive news, which I will share with you, and for which I think that I find the definitive clue, the definitive proof that it's just about to happen, and it could happen as soon as tomorrow, I want to tell you that there are big risks associated with any investment, specifically when you're investing in SPACs. I also want to make sure that you understand risks of investing in the SPAC right now, and make sure that you click that and smash that like button, because it really helps with the YouTube algorithm. Because when you're investing in SPACs, you're not investing in a company, you're investing in a special purpose acquisition company. That's what SPAC stands for, which is just empty shell company. They have no business, they have no CEOs, they have nothing, they have no employees, they're not providing any value to the marketplace. It's just a huge pile of cash sitting around, ready to be put out there into some other company, merge with it, bring it public, hoping that some other people will purchase more stock, bringing that stock of that newly traded, public traded company up and making money. But SPACs are a very good vehicle to, and much more easier to use and cheaper, cheaper vehicle to use to bring any privately held company public. The traditional IPO route is a lot longer and a lot more, much more expensive route to bring the company public. With that being said, I also want to say that, and you will check that out in the news, that Lucid Motors has announced in one of the earlier announcements that they're planning to start the development of the Lucid Air, their premium model of a car, and start delivering the car in the, I think, mid-June or July 2021. And now this is like five, six months from now, which in my opinion is not enough time to prepare a traditional IPO route, okay? So I think that that's one of the proofs that why this merger can happen and can happen soon. Now, let's check out the other news and other clues and proofs for which I think can be a definitive proof that that's about to happen very, very soon. So let's check it out. So before we check out the good news, proofs and clues that are almost definitive that the merger is going down, I want you to be aware of the risks. And when I'm talking about risks, there are also news that are saying that this merger is not about to go down and that it might never happen. So let's check out those news first from the CNBC and what they have announced and what kind of thinking they have. Okay, let's go. So on this article on Seeking Alpha, Churchill Capital 4 deal with Lucid Motors might not happen, and that CNBC says, okay? So these are a few, you know, paragraphs from their news announced on January 14th, where they announced Michael Klein's Churchill Capital 4 SPAC deal with Lucid Motors may not happen after a report that a transaction may occur. So that's kind of fuzzy, you know? First they are saying that it's going to happen, now they're announcing that it might not happen. So, very much unclear if they will make a deal. No way it's a done deal. CCIV is second largest SPAC. Okay, so we know that. I covered that in my latest video as well. And CCIV, the Churchill Capital 4 shares, are down 0.6% after pairing earlier gains. The shares climbed 67% this week through yesterday, including a 32% increase on Monday after Bloomberg reported on potential Lucid deal, which is good. This is good. So we know a lot of this stuff that's shared here is good, but you know, the tricky part here is that CNBC said and confirmed that it might not happen at all. So this is kind of, you know, if anything, you should look at this merger with a positive skepticism. right? So you should have a bit of a skepticism, but also should have a bit of a hope that it will happen. Because in my opinion, after we go through all of these news, you will see that there are much more evidence and proof that it's about to go down. Because as shared in the previous video, there are people sitting on a Lucid Motors board and there are people sitting in a Churchill capital. Those people are basically the same people which helped each other, and which Churchill Capital, basically people sitting on the board of members, board of directors, or they're part of a Lucid Motors, they're part of the Churchill Capital fund, which helped Lucid Motors in one of their earlier investment rounds. So that's one of the biggest reasons, right? If you helped them before, there could be a chance that you're gonna bring them public, you know? I mean, obviously, just my opinion. Okay, so let's check out the good news as well. Okay, so one of the first news here is circumstantial Churchill Capital for Lucid Motors, evidence is why I'm still in. And this is a news article on Seeking Alpha from a guy called Bram de Haas, who has over 15,000 followers. And in summary, he took a look at the Churchill Capital Motors rumors, because there is nothing else, there is no, you know, it's just rumors still, it's not a definitive, nothing is definitive until it gets announced and until it happens. But over the last week, he did find a lot of rumors and a lot of positive news that it's about to go down. And in short, he's still riding Churchill Capital 4. With the shares at around $18, he still believes that Churchill Capital will surge upwards if a deal with Lucid is confirmed. But also, just like I do, he also wants to point out a risk. Because, look, he also believes that it will fall back to maybe around $13 range and possibly below if there is a no deal. If there is no news, I'd expect the shares to slowly decline. Now, why is he saying that? Because it's very, very normal. If the deal is not getting announced, you know, people are buying the hype right now because there is, you know, thinking and assumptions that it could go down. But if it doesn't happen, a lot of people who put their money up will be largely disappointed. So what's going to happen? They will start selling those shares, and those people who got in a SPAC at around $10 since it opened will probably get some profit out of it. But the people who got in at $20, $18 could not get a profit, will end up with a loss. Now, this is also a huge risk, and one of the clues when I started thinking about it, why I think it can happen and it will happen, why I think actually it will happen. Because look, those people behind this pack, Churchill Capital, are very well known in the industries, right? And now they're allowing a hype to bring up the prices of shares. Now, if they disappoint a lot of the investors, they're losing their credibility. And I don't think anybody with this kind of, this large sums of money and this good reputation wants to ruin their own reputation. So that's why I think they're allowed the hype to bring up the shares. So when it gets announced, it will push up the prices of a share even higher and higher, hence making them even more and more money. So that's an interesting way of looking at it, but I think that there could be something, because now if they disappoint a lot of the investors, the shares are going to drop, and eventually if they want to, you know, create a news pack and bring some other company public, you have a reputation to, you know, to protect. And now you will be, if you fail, yeah, you will not have as good as reputation as if you were to win. So that's something to bear in mind as well. Now, let's dig into it in this article, because in this article there is a good schematics how the people between Churchill Capital and Lucid Motors are connected. So that's going to be interesting to look at.
Okay, so that's very short for the risk, but if you check out here on the Alex Cutler on Twitter, see, he says update via source, so we are assuming that he has internal source. Meeting was about going public, all right? Okay, good. Lucid Motors plans to go public by April. So that's even a shorter, yeah, no, right, that's good. By April, so that they can start distributing vehicles by June. So that's something that I shared, you know, that I mentioned in the beginning of a video. There's very short time span they need to pull this off, right? So they can neither confirm nor deny using the reverse merger pathway to go public. That would be a pathway with SPACs, But that's the clearly the fastest way to hit this deadline. That's also announced on Twitter on January 15th. So they have basically 3 months, and there is no way they can pull the, you know, IPO in the 3 months. So just like this guy shared, I think it's too late if they wanted an IPO. This generally takes much more longer. Now, scrolling down, you can check out this chart that I said. So on the left side, we have Churchill Capital 4, and on the right side, we have Lucid. So I'm just going to let you go to check out this article, to check out these schematics and see how these companies are already very much related and connected. So that's why this is one of the biggest proofs that I saw that, right, you know, if I'm sitting here, if I'm the CEO and I help here operating partner to the, you know, Lucid already, right? And then I'm here in Churchill Capital, I'm operating partner here, and I've helped Saudi Public Investment Fund invested in Magic Leap, Saudi's government invested in Digital Globe, and also connected with Lucid. So, right, there's too much connections for this to be disregarded, and that's one of the biggest reasons why I think that eventually the merger will be announced. Now, with that being said, I also want you to check out this Twitter post. I don't know who this guy's Moonshot Stocks is, but if you take a look at a Bloomberg terminal here, and this was on January the 20th, like 4 days ago, you will see that if you type in the Lucid Motors in the equity in the Bloomberg terminal, you can see that the proposed acquirer is Churchill Capital.
If this is not enough, I really do not know what is, right? I think this is one of the biggest proofs. This, along with the, you know, the schematics that I showed you, this is like basically, you know, that's it. It's a done deal.
Now, let's see one more. Also, I want to end up this video basically saying that Lucid Motors expect to have a breakthrough year. So if you're feeling that you might be a bit late
on this road up, on this ride up of a stock of a Churchill Capital, you know, remember why you are investing. Are you investing just to have a pop when the SPACs go public, when the SPACs announces a merger, or you're more of a long-term investor? Because Lucid Motors is a brand new company. It's about to go public via SPAC merger. That's what we assume. And in the long run, in 10, 20 years, there's a, you know, it's possibility they will be one of the biggest players in the market. Sure, it will take a long time. There will be a lot of hurdles, but we gotta remember why we are investing. Are we long-term holders or just, you know, Robin Hood newbies investors that are just looking to double, triple their stocks very soon? Because that's not what investing is all about. Sure, SPACs and penny stocks are a good vehicle to double, triple, quadruple your money, but they're also very, very risky. And now, with that being said, I just want to wrap up this video and make sure you click that like button, smash it up, because it really helps with the YouTube algorithm to bring this video to as many people as possible and help them possibly. Now, with that being said, thank you very much for watching this video, and talk to you soon.